Jay is a student that we met on the student union with Occupy Education. Really, he writes for the Cooperative Catalyst. He's a very powerful voice in trying to change education.
Think like you're a kid and act like you're an adult. Because when you act like you're an adult and you think like you're an adult, the kid really has to catch up to you. So it should be the other way around.
Yeah, I think I'd add on to that. I think you need to treat kids like adults or treat them on a very high standard. Treat them like the professionals. At least in the classroom, I think there's a huge discrepancy where we see kids acting not as creators of content but as consumers of it. We need to treat them more as the scientists, the artists, the professors. And that's where we need to see the shift, I think.
Children are evolutionarily more advanced than adults, just naturally. They always will be, you know, emotionally, physically, intellectually, spiritually, I think is really essential.
We created a parameter where the kids could have real input into an art, into what is essentially my artistic project, and to be able to give them space within those parameters so that we end up with a really quality finished product.
We did a writing prompt in science class, and he said it was writing prompt day, and everybody went, because we don't have anything fun to write about it. I mean,
yes.
It could be if you wanted it to be.
And my goal as the art side of this equation is to give these kids enough material that lights them up, that they are motivated to communicate and motivated to write. So I give them a good topic, I'm not really going to control it. You know, if they do what we need them to do, we'll come up with it. The piece will be beautiful. Mm-hmm. And they can't fail. There's no, you know, which is really neat. We set them up for success.
And then you said earlier that you set it up in an environment where they can't fail, which is kind of nice, but it's kind of discouraging because failure is, when it's an option, it makes it more interesting.
Why do you think the government's telling teachers to teach what they teach instead of, like, other things, like exploring what students want to learn and, like, the questions that they ask, like, you know?
And it's all this kind of medicine from the corporation kind of model where you have to put carrots in front of teachers or you slap them with accountability measures, like, we'll fire you if the scores don't go up. So there's all these terrible policies.
I don't think people are evil just all the time. What would be your advice to teachers? Since it's teachers teaching teachers, to listen better. How could they hear the voices better?
Really just having listening sessions. Start by having your students work in groups and hear what they're thinking. I mean, it's kind of ironic that we're not even listening to the people who are being educated. Whatever you're doing in the curriculum tomorrow, and start by creating various groups of students, asking what they love to do, and you'll learn so much more. Your classes will be so much better, and they will love you as a teacher. I will guarantee that. Start by working and participating more in these kind of webinars and Twitter chats. I think that's where you find people who are going through the same problems that you are and can help you, because it's you didn't learn this in graduate education school.